Well, it's been a little while since I did an updated shop tour, so I figured I would do one real quick and show the progress of the miter saw station, Jay Bates design, which is over to the left of the camera. But let's take a quick tour. All right, so we'll start in the back. Grinder, wire wheel, use that once in a while, not that much. Still got the rigid drill press with the WEN table. The table's awesome. I just used it last night to drill the mount or the hole for the bolt for my stop block. Worked awesome. Clamp rack hasn't changed much. I actually want to buy some longer Bessie clamps, some 36 inch, but there hasn't really been a need. It's more of a want, so I held off. And that's on a French clamp rack, so I can take that down, put something else there or whatever. It's not attached. And underneath, got the DeWalt planer and my first rolling cabinet that I built. I have a door on the other side. Let's see if we can get this out of here. Sorry for the bad camera work. So, under here I got most of my WEN tools. Router, track saw, hand planer. Hand planer I don't really use. I got that when I first started. And track saw. And then up top is my DeWalt biscuit cutter. And then my high-tech hinge or lock system. Just a nail and a lock. Works pretty good. And in there just miscellaneous router bits, some countersink bits, whatnot. My rack for all my battery-operated drills, drivers, and some of my air tools. I probably use that the most out of anything I built. And then up top, just some extra storage. And these doors, it's just plywood with accent pieces on top. And this actually just fit in here. It's not even glued or anything on. I was just messing around. Wanted to make it look a little bit different. So that's still the same. The big change would be, there we go, I was zoomed in, sorry about that, is the Jay Bates miter saw station. So as you can see, let me actually get a better angle for you. The main parts of it are all built and in. There, you can see all of it now. So those two right here and here, I just had old cabinets. They're actually in the garage when I bought this house. So I've been using them as for storage, and I will until I finish building the drawers for the station. I built one so far. I got to build a bunch more. I'll probably do that section first so I can put all my tools in there, and then I'll just get rid of those. But so far, it's going well. I finished the stop block system last night. It's the Craig, 2 4-foot sections of Craig mini jig or mini track. And then I have a piece of, this was a piece of oak plywood that I put the dado in. This is the same tape measure that Jay used on his. And I was really surprised. I think it's metal, just really thin metal. It's fairly sturdy. I thought it was just going to be a real thin, like, paper tape, but it's not. So it's really cool. Stop block. And I couldn't find a knob that would work that I like, so I had some spare red oak. So I just made one myself, and you know, it works. Tighten it up. Used it last night to cut a couple things. Works really well. Simple, but works well. Miter stall is still the same. DeWalt compound sliding. And I just have the 2.5-inch hose hooked up to the dust port, which doesn't do much. And then I have a second one there just to get some of it. I haven't closed it yet. This is one of my modifications, just a piece of cardboard and a V. It does help get a lot more of the dust funneled up in there. What I want to do is get more of a material like this, like a rubber, where I can attach it somehow and have it be permanent. Because right now I have to adjust that all the time, but it does make a difference. You can see the dust shooting up there, where but prior to that it didn't work. So my probably second most used piece is the rolling assembly outfeed slash infeed table. I got a removable vise. Use this thing all the time, and it's made from all plywood. Great table. And those casters I got from Home Depot, locking swivels. they're awesome. This is by far a great table. Up top, the last time I did this, I don't know if I had the Wen air filter. It's quiet. It works really well. As you can see, you can see it's got a good amount of dust in the filters. Probably gonna have to clean that out soon. It's worked really well. It's quiet. Turn it on for you. That's on high. Not too loud. Does a really good job. I use that a lot. Still working with the Craftsman job site saw. For little cuts, it's awesome with the Diablo blade. When I'm breaking down full sheets of plywood, it's sometimes it's dangerous, so I can't wait to get the Grizzly. Still saving up for it. I'm close, but it's not really a need. It's more of a want, so I try to save up money for it. This is a hand-me-down from my wife's parents, rigid oscillating spindle sander with the Diablo sandpaper blade. Kicks ass. I'm using that rigid vac for my dust collector right now. The dust deputy with a couple blast gates. Works pretty good. I was using two of these drums, but I turned it on without opening a blast gate and it collapsed it. I probably could salvage it if I make a frame on the inside, but it's not really worth the work right now. And today I cleaned up this whole area because it was kind of a mess. So as much as it pains me to throw away my cutoffs and extra wood, I just had to because it was cluttered and it was a mess. So I got over here is mostly pine, you know, softwood, plywood, some more plywood there. This is more, there's a, I think a 2x4 on the bottom, but poplar. And then up top, more 2x4s with some pine behind it. You can't see in the back. I have all that is red oak in the back. Grizzly 6-inch joiner, still kicking ass. Got it for $250 on Craigslist. It's an awesome joiner for me. I mean, obviously everyone wants an 8-inch, but this one does the job. The Jet bandsaw, also kicking ass. Haven't had to switch the blade yet. It's a great thing. I think I got it for $375 on Craigslist with the rolling base. And then just some scrap wood. I couldn't throw it all out. That is a lot of my storage right now, these old cabinets. So once I get more drawers made on the upper cabinets on the miter saw station, that'll get emptied and thrown out. I think those were the kitchen cabinets in this house. I think. I didn't build that. That was left over from the kitchen remodel. I did build this sliding barn door cabinet. Tried to sell it for like $200. Didn't get any bites, but I see they're selling them for like $250, $300 in stores now. I made it out of select pine, mostly. I made the hardware, that's just a piece of aluminum spray painted black with a bushing, and it's screwed right into the cabinet. Those wheels are from clothesline pulley, and then they're just, you know, a bolt through it with more of the aluminum screwed into the door I glued up. I think it looks pretty cool, but I haven't got really many people want to buy it. So I don't know, maybe if I try painting it a different color, put a design on the door, it might sell. As you can see, that is the majority of the shop right there. And that's about a third of the basement, because back there I got a bunch more storage, door to outside, and then, you know, the rest over here. Pretty big basement. There you go. That's the shop.